What is going on, guys? In this video, I'm going to show you guys how to paint
a Honda transmission.
It's generally pretty simple. All you got to do is you're going to have to tape everything off like this. Anything that you feel like is important and should not be painted, like, oh, I don't know, threads and cables and sensors and stuff like that, is what you're going to mainly want to focus on. So if you ever want to clean it up, I use some oven cleaner. Pretty much any oven cleaner works, and it's gonna get it nice and smooth like this, no grease, and don't worry about any like little cracks like that. It's nothing. So all you're gonna do is, if you want, you can sand it down. It just depends what grade job you want, you know what I'm saying? I'm just going for bare minimum. It's a quick color change, but yeah, so right quick, I'm just gonna go ahead and spray it with a light coat, and then after we get the light coat, we're gonna go ahead and step it up a little bit more, and we'll apply the third and final coat. And then that should be enough. All right, so I try to do a light coat. My bad. I try to do a light coat. But with all the wind and stuff like that, I think I'm gonna win a little bit heavy. But like I said, I'm going bare minimum. This isn't a show car at all. So we're just gonna wait for it to dry. I'm gonna give it about 5-10 minutes, and then we're gonna go ahead and apply the second coat. So I'll go ahead and see you guys there. All right, so it's been a little bit less than 5 minutes. I think it's pretty much dried already. Touch, you know, we'll give it maybe a little bit longer. But if you start to see things like this, don't worry about it. It's just the first coat, all right? So, try to do it in a controlled environment, like inside of a shop and stuff, but you know, the shop is crowded and I don't have any masks or anything. It's been tough out here. I'm looking for a way out. No, I'm just joking, but yeah, so right now I'm gonna just go ahead and say F it. Sorry, come on, Ken. Say F it, go ahead and start on the second coat. I'm so sorry if it's extremely windy out here. I really can't do anything about it. This is the best I could do, so. If I can do some editing and get that noise out of the way, I could, but I mean, I've seen the quality of videos out there. I mean, come on, guys. Come on.
Second coat.
Second coat is done. All right, and the part that is gonna be seen the most, this right here, is looking, I wouldn't say bad, but it needs some adjustments, some improvements. So what we're gonna do is, since the wind is blowing that way and it's kind of causing some stuff to happen, on the other side it's looking great, but that's the bottom side, so we have no use for that. I'm gonna wait till it dries, and I'm gonna go ahead and do a full 180, so that way we can get some good painting surface on that. And yeah, so looking around, there's some spots I missed, like right here. So I'm gonna go ahead and touch that up before I let it dry. But yeah, next is the third and final coat. I might do an extra coat, maybe two extra coats, depending on what I need. But so far, it's looking decent. Like I said, it's not a show car, so yeah. All right, so as you can see, I got the transmission turned around and I'm ready to paint the other side. So I'll go ahead and get on the third and final coat. Like I said, I might need a few more coats, but generally, if you're doing this inside, you would only need 3 coats, bare minimum. I mean, you guys can go crazy if you guys want, use a paint gun, I don't know. This is a backyard build, you know what I'm saying? I'm not too worried about it, but it's gonna be probably the best backyard build that I can possibly do. Like I said, I don't have that much knowledge about what I'm doing, but it is what it is. And if you guys get to see some great stuff, you can do it too. So, here we go.
All right, so at this point, a lot of people would be satisfied. There are some flaws in the paint. But I mean, if you guys want, just, I mean, that was just one can basically. I could have just finished it with the other can because there's a little bit less, there's a little bit left. And I mean, it came out pretty good. With one can, I got the transmission as well as the engine painted. And I mean, this looks pretty good. I think I might apply one more coat. There's some blemishes, like stuff like that. That's part of not prepping correctly, not sanding. And even though I did degrease the engine, I should have degreased it again today before I started painting. But you know, like I said, I'm like rushing to get this thing done so I can go spend some time with my wife. And but I mean, as far as the paint goes, I mean, one can get you the entire block and the entire transmission. About three coats, two. One for the transmission and one for the block, a light coat, and then two heavy coats. So a total of six coats. But if you're outside, you're gonna probably wanna apply a few more. But like I said, if you guys are content with what this looks like, go ahead and leave it how it is. But I think I might just give it one more go because it started to look a little bit better on this side. I never showed you guys it before, but it was like really gritty how it is. Like, I don't know if it's gonna focus, but like right there, but it was like way more. So I got a little bit of it out by just being a little bit heavy-handed. But like I said, I'm gonna go ahead and do one more coat, give it about 5 minutes. I'm gonna let this one dry the most. I'm gonna give it maybe 5-10. I don't know. I'm gonna just go inside, talk some BS, and then come back out, and then whatever happens, happens. So see you then. All right, so pretty much we didn't really do any engine work today besides like prep work or, you know, stuff like that. But we got everything painted up. So instead of this being a engine rebuild video, this is strictly gonna be how to paint your transmission, block, and head. So the only thing I really covered was how to paint, I believe, the engine and transmission, and by engine I mean the block. So all you pretty much have to do is follow the same steps for pretty much everything else. Everything's really, really simple. I mean, all the fundamentals are all you need. I mean, I only had help with the block, and I did the head, I did the transmission all by myself. So like I said, it's really simple. Anyone can do it. Like, don't let all that crazy shit you see on Instagram get to your head, man. Anything you can do with just patience, and you know, as long as you know you can do quality work, you will. Just have confidence to do it. But anyways, guys, thanks for watching. I appreciate all the love and support, everyone that's been supporting me, shouting me out, and you know, getting me out there. I really appreciate that. I would love to feature some of you guys. If you guys stay in Texas, or if I'm ever on leave back to the States, I'll bring the camera. You know, we'll go out, shoot some videos. I do not mind, man. You know, you guys help me out, I'm gonna help you guys out too. So like I said, like and subscribe if you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.